Which of the following anatomic relationships would be seen when a surgeon exposes the region around the beginning of the jejunum during laparotomy? So this is the region here that is in question. Here's, you can see the C-shaped duodenum, and this is the fourth part of the duodenum, and then becoming intraperitoneal and forming the jejunum. And so the question is asking about the relations that can be seen around this region in the upper abdominal viscera. The first choice is the second part of the duodenum is located posterior to the hilum of the right kidney. Here you can see this is the right kidney in here. And of course, this is the first part of the duodenum. Second part of the duodenum is in fact located in the front of the hilum of the right kidney. Both of them are retroperitoneal structures. So this option is wrong. Second option B, the superior mesenteric artery and vein. Here's the superior mesenteric artery and vein. The option says that the superior mesenteric artery and vein pass posterior to the third part of the duodenum. In fact, they both pass anterior to the third part of the duodenum. They are located in the mesentery of the small intestine. And this is the attachment of the root of the mesentery of the small intestine. It is attached at the side, the left side of L2 vertebra, and then it crosses the midline and goes down into the right iliac region. While doing so, it crosses the third part of the duodenum, which is retroperitoneal, and as it crosses the third part of the duodenum, the superior mesenteric artery and vessels that pass in front of the third part of the duodenum will gain access to the mesentery of the small intestine. So this option is wrong. The third option, C, the portal vein crosses anterior to the neck of the pancreas. The portal vein, in fact, is formed by the union of the superior mesenteric vein and the splenic vein. So they unite behind the neck of the pancreas to form the portal vein that goes into the liver. So it is behind the neck of the pancreas at the level of the transpyloric plane, and not in front of the neck of the pancreas. The second part of the duodenum is crossed anteriorly. This is option D. The second part of the duodenum is crossed anteriorly by the attachment of the transverse colon. And this option is right because the attachment of the transverse colon, the transverse mesocolon, mesentery of the transverse colon, is in fact located horizontally across the posterior abdominal wall. It crosses the pancreas, crosses the second part of the duodenum, and divides the peritoneal cavity into supracolic and infracolic compartments. So it crosses the second part of the duodenum, as I mentioned, that the second part of the duodenum is also a retroperitoneal part. By the way, the four parts of the duodenum are retroperitoneal, except for the beginning of the first part of the duodenum, where it is connected to the liver by the hepatoduodenal ligament, whose free border contains the hepatic triad, portal vein, hepatic artery, and bile duct. And the terminal part of the fourth part of the duodenum, which is connected to the jejunum at the duodeno-jejunal junction, where it becomes intraperitoneal. All the other parts are retroperitoneal, and we have seen that the third part is crossed by the mesentery of the small intestine, and now the second part is crossed by the mesentery of the transverse colon. The last option, E, the third part of the duodenum is related anteriorly to the hilum of the left kidney. This is wrong. The third part of the duodenum reaches the side of the L3 vertebra, and it doesn't really reach the hilum of the kidney. The hilum of the kidney is a little bit higher up and more to the left. And in fact, it is crossed by the pancreas and is not related to the duodenum.